But, you know, back in the old days, and I'm not even talking about the biblical days, but back in the old days, you didn't fall in love first. The daddy arranged the marriage. Glory, glory. I'm trying to do it right now. I'm trying to, if I can arrange marriage for my, right now, if I could find a guy and bring and hook it up, I would hook it up in a minute. Oh yeah, Danielle and Leah, I'd find them, right? If I could find them. I'm looking, by the way, I'm looking. Try to arrange it, right? And then later on, they can fall in love. They can learn how to love. The first thing that you need, because you can't sleep on love. You can't sleep on I felt good. You can't eat on love. You can't buy a house on love. I wish somebody here would say amen. And some of y'all here know what I'm talking about. You gotta have a little bit more than love. You gotta have some money. Some money, I'm not talking about rich. You ain't got to marry a rich man, but he got to at least be able to take care of you. How are you going to get married and the man can't take care of you? That's what I don't understand. You say, well, now I'm just going to trust him, and I know he's a good man. He's a good broke man, honey. You better make sure you understand that. And it's very important that you understand that. Amen. He ain't got no money. Now you say, well, that'll be because I'm in love right there. I'm going to tell you how long in love lasts. It'll last for about 6 months. And then you'll see that man you're in love with, when you get up, he's still in the bed. And then when you come home, he laying on the couch with some popcorn and a beer flicking the machine. Yeah, your love will wear out. I'm telling you that right now. You'll take love and throw it out on the street corner. And guess what? Somebody that you younger, you older women, you know what I'm talking about. You better get with these girls and let them know the deal. You know the deal. That's when you laughing. You know the deal. I'm almost finished now. Somebody say, keep it real, Pastor, keep it real. Okay, good, keep it real, I heard you. Keep us at home. Now, you men need to read this right. It says keepers at home. It didn't say keep her at home. Y'all been clapping long enough. You've been having fun long enough. Going in preaching, Pastor. Pat me on the back now, y'all. Come on, pat me now. Keep the woman at home. That ain't what the Bible say. Keep the woman at home. Lock her up. Some men want to just lock up. When you find somebody that want to lock you up, you can't even be yourself. You are self before you married him. You got to have your own identity. You got to have your own personality. You got to have your own spirit. Don't let no man kill your spirit. These men or something, they'll change everything about you. And you change you ever in a relationship where you change everything the man say and he still got a problem? Well, you know, I'd like for you to walk like this. I'd like for your hair to look like this. I'd like for you to like that. Now hold it, buddy. That's enough. When you met me, this is how I looked.
But let me get back to this, the keepers at home. Very, very interesting here, keepers at home. You know, home is a very important thing. And by the way, what happens in the home is more valuable than what happens anywhere else in this world. And you say, well, what? Because God wouldn't put that emphasis on the home like that if it wasn't important.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He doesn't never waste words. He never wastes time.
Yes, sir. Yes,
it's important.
Yes.
But today in this society, home doesn't have much value. I was reading a story about a woman who moved from city to city, and the realtor said to her, offered her, I'll help you find a home. And she replied, I don't need a home. She said, I was born in a hospital. I was educated in the college. I was married in the church. I live at a delicatessen. I go play golf in the morning. In the afternoons, I play bridge. In the evenings, I go to the movies. When I die, they're going to bury me by an undertaker. I don't need a home. I need a garage. And the way some people live, they don't need a home. They need a garage. Because we get so busy. We get so busy that we don't have time for each other anymore. We're so busy chasing that almighty dollar that we don't have any time to sit. We don't have any time to pray. We don't have any time for anything. And so here was my policy when this in my marriage. My policy was that, okay, home is first. But the kids right now are this age. This got to be taken care of. We can't raise children by proxy. Now there are times when you're going to have to work, I think. But when those times come, it shall not be because it's a want. It's got to be because of a need. I don't ever want to take my wife out of the home while my kids are young so we can get something we want. Because my children are more important than the things that we want. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Not based upon my greed, but based upon our need. That's when the woman is to leave. And I know that we live in a world where we all have to work and both parents are working, but it must be out of a necessity. It can't be that you want a diamond ring or another fur coat because your child is more important than any fur coat that you're going to put on your body. Your child is more important than that new car. Your child is more important than a new house. Your child is more important. And so you must never, ever trade and bargain the most precious thing in your life away for filthy lucre.
Do you understand what I mean?
Yes.
Oh, sure, we got to work. We got to pay the bills. That's a need. Go and work, both of you work, and try to figure out how you do it. You got to figure it out. And a good man, is going to think like that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
A godly man is going to think like that. He's not going to be pushing his wife out to work so he can get another car. Talked to the guy the other day. He said, man, I got married about a year ago, man, but boy, this thing, I didn't know it was going to be like this. I said, what do you mean, man? I'm on the plane. He don't know who I am or I'm preaching. I said, hey, what? But, I didn't know it was going to be like this. I said, how's it going to be? He said, no. I said, how it is now? I said, no, how's it going to be? What are you getting ready to do is what I'm asking you, man. So I can't take it. I said, tell me what the issues are. Well, man, you know, we started working. We're working together. She had a job. I had a job. And we had a kid. And after we had the kid, she'd come talking about she want to stay home for a while with the kid.
Come on, explain.
Well,
I said,
and where you want the kid to be. You do got the little issue here. You got your own flesh and blood, man, that needs to be nurtured, that needs to be handled by his or her own mother, if possible. Let me ask you something, man. How much money you make? Oh, I can do it by myself. I don't need her to work. And so I say, if you don't need her to work, let her stay home with that kid.